Welcome back. So I'm going to go and talk about trying to set up here, guys. I'm going to talk about a few other herbs that I have, and I'm going to jar them today as well. Now, the first one I'm going to do is neem leaf. Neem leaf is one of the ones that I personally like to use in products. So I like to use neem leaf for hair products. It's really, really good for the hair. I haven't really dove into using neem, N-E-E-M leaf, into anything else but hair products so far. So I'm going to use a smaller jar. I'm pretty sure it's not going to fit in here all, but I will just leave the package back, and I'll be using the rest of it to go ahead and make like a neem oil. So I'll probably come back and talk about how I make the neem oil, but for right now, this is how I'm gonna jar it. So again, neem is one of those herbs I like to extract the properties from, to add in like to oil product, you know. Or if like I'm making a body butter, sometimes I make butters that I like to use to condition my natural hair. So neem leaf would be one of the ones I would use. Now this one, I'm going to do rose hips. I haven't used rose hips yet, but I did get it for beauty products. So I haven't had a chance to add it into other stuff. I do use the oil on a regular basis, but the reason why I bought this was to be able to produce my own rose hip oil. That way I know exactly what I'm getting. And just basically place it in a jar, and I'm going to be extracting the same type of properties that the people, you know, that sell it does. So, and this will make me a lot. This will make me a lot of rose hip oil. So, let me get my little sticker. Uh-oh, I think I wrote it on the wrong one. I'm gonna rewrite it. So yeah, rose hips is used for a lot of beauty products. So, you know, I've seen people use it like similar to the other one. Neem is used in you know, body butters and stuff like that too. So I want to make my own oil, so I'll be working on that soon. I'm gonna rewrite this one too. So sometimes I will order and I won't be able to receive it in a herbal form. So I just kind of go ahead and get the powder. So one of the ones I don't mind getting powder is amala. Amala is one that I'll be using for, well, I've already used some for hair oil. But yeah, this is really, really good for the hair, you know, hair growth and things of that nature, keeping it strong and healthy. So we'll drop this one in there. So I don't have to have these just sitting around in a bag, you know. I built up my collection of herbs, and I'm like, girl, if you don't put these herbs to use, well, I've used them, but share. So that is the amala powder. I'm going to label that as well, put that to the side. Yarrow is a powder that I use. It has a lot of different medicinal properties, but I only talk about my personal experience. I'm not telling anybody how to use it. I'm telling you how I use it. So yarrow is one. Well, I got this one first of all is because I couldn't get the actual yarrow leaf or herb. I like to add the yarrow into my yoni steams. So this is a product that has been used for that. I'm pretty sure it has other medicinal properties, but this is the one that I ordered just for those purposes. So say if I ever, you know, if I'm ever able to find the actual herb, I will order it. But I can go ahead and when I prepare my steam, I can go ahead and put that inside of it. So that's that. And whatever's left over, I'm gonna put up, and once I, you know, that's that. So let me make sure I say this one correctly. Calendula flowers, yeah. So normally I will put this in a large jar because this is something that I use on a regular basis for yoni steams as well, like the natural flower. But because I don't have, it's very rare that I get these. Well, first of all, it's very rare that I can find them in stock. So I'm just going to go ahead and put them in a little jar today. But this is another flower that's really, really good in using, that I personally use in yoni steams. Now, it has other medicinal purposes, but again, I'm not here to tell anybody. You do your own research and, you know, proceed that way. But yeah, so this is a really, really great one that I love. And like I said, you know, quals were all great things. That's probably why it's so difficult to find. But I'm going to add my little written label to it. And again, I'm going to come back at another time after everything is already organized and then go through and print out the medicinal properties that I choose to use it for. And I'm going to label it that way when I organize my shelf, I don't have to remember everything about certain products. Anyway, that's it for those five. And I believe I have a few more that I want to share, and that's going to be in a different video. I didn't want to make this too long. I'm back, guys.